Got amateur radio operators coming up with a big event for that. It's about talking about national disasters. They're the people that, you know, swing into action when happens. Gordon's here with us and is coming up this weekend.
Amateur Radio Field Day. How fun is that? Is this an opportunity for people to come out and just figure out what you do?
It is. It's Field Day. It's our open house. It's open house people understand. Come out, see us. We're at Coastal Science Building. About a 2 par 5s away from here.
Not too far at all.
Right down the road.
What are they going to learn? What are people going to learn when they come out?
They're going to learn what we do, how we can communicate in emergencies. We'll even have a station where we can get them on air.
Very cool. And why it's something that we don't, you know, this kind of technology, we don't want to lose it. It's very important. When all else fails, here you go.
Exactly. And last year we had a girl about 12, 13 come by. She spent about a half hour talking with a ham operator in Argentina.
Oh,
really?
She was so excited about it and, you know, really just great. Loved to share that with everyone.
So a great opportunity to bring your kids and let them learn about something that, you know, I would say a lot of kids probably don't know about.
Yes.
They don't?
And it fits in beautifully with the STEM program in the schools because it shows practical applications.
I know, and I tell you, I learned this a long time ago. My neighbor, he used to talk to his son on a ham radio all the way to Hawaii, and I thought that was the coolest thing in the world. Now, you can talk how far with this little thing?
Can talk around the state.
Around the state.
Yeah.
All right. Now, at home, you can talk where? Anywhere in the world?
Anywhere in the world.
And this is amazing.
And to the International Space Station.
Wow. Now, this is amazing. In case of disaster, you lose all your communications.
Right.
These guys keep it going for us and let us know everything that's going on.
Exactly.
Very cool. How long have you been doing this? Into it?
About 20, 25 years.
And let me show you something else. Now, we were talking about pictures a minute ago.
Thank you.
He takes pictures and sends out these cards to everybody. And he likes photography, too.
Yeah, very cool.
And that's pretty good.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Gives me a way to share Myrtle Beach with the world.
All right. Now, tell them when it starts and everything and who's invited.
Starts at 2 p.m. Saturday, runs through the wee hours of Sunday. And everyone's invited.
Where's it at? Tell them where.
Coastal Carolina Science Building in the Atlantic Center for Business and Industry.
That is
fantastic.
So cool. Well, I'll tell
Thanks
you what.
Thanks for being on. We always enjoy it when you come on. It's so interesting.
Gordon, thank you for what you do, buddy. We appreciate it. That's your call letters, W4EGM.
Yep.
That's right. They do call letters. I knew that.